The large majority of cases of sleep apnea in the population go undiagnosed. And for those people who know anything about sleep apnea, to them, it's just a pause in sleep at night. But sleep apnea is much more than that. And a CPAP machine may save your life. Stick around to learn more. Sleep apnea is a condition in which people stop breathing during their sleep. If you stop breathing for 10 or more seconds, 5 or more times per hour, you can be diagnosed with sleep apnea. There are two main types of sleep apnea. There is obstructive sleep apnea, in which the tissues in the upper airways collapse and cause a blockage in the upper airways. And there is central sleep apnea, in which the breathing center in the brain fails to drive the breathing muscles and the diaphragm to breathe. In both of these, the result is a decrease in the oxygen saturation in the blood and an increase in the level of carbon dioxide in the blood. Our bodies have sensors in the brain and in the large arteries in the neck that can sense these changes. And by sensing these changes, they trigger a fight or flight response, which is a response in the body that emerges whenever we are facing danger. The result is a deluge of catecholamines and other hormones that flood the system. And this can lead to changes in the body, such as racing of the heart and tightening of the arteries in the body. Our bodies struggle against the obstruction in the upper airways. And during the process of struggling to get more oxygen and to rid the body of the carbon dioxide that has built up, a large negative pressure is created in the chest cavity. This negative pressure stretches the heart and the large arteries and vessels and veins that are contained in the chest cavity. In the upper part of the heart, known as the atrium, there is embedded in the atrial muscle a sensor, a mechanoreceptor, that can sense the stretching and that leads to the secretion of atrial natriuretic peptide, a hormone that leads to the production of urine. As a result of this, people with obstructive sleep apnea can have what we call polyuria at night, nocturia, the need to go to the bathroom frequently to urinate. The atria also contain a pacemaker that controls the rate of the heartbeat. And this is damaged while the negative pressure builds up in the chest and stretches the atrial wall. And this can lead to irregular heartbeats, in particular atrial fibrillation, which is a frequent finding in people with obstructive sleep apnea. The low oxygen levels in the blood cause the lining of the arteries, known as the endothelial cells, to secrete a hormone known as endothelin. Endothelin is one of the strongest vasoconstrictors that we know. A vasoconstrictor is a hormone that can cause tightening or narrowing of the arteries in the body. The result is there is a narrowing of the arteries throughout the body that can lead to a rise in blood pressure and eventually to chronic hypertension. Endothelin also exerts its influence on the arteries in the lung, leading to narrowing of these arteries and an increase in the blood pressure in the arteries, leading to a condition that is sometimes fatal, known as pulmonary hypertension. When the arteries feeding the heart react to endothelin and narrow, the supply of blood to the heart is decreased, and there is a starvation of the heart muscle of oxygen. And this can lead to death of the heart muscle tissue causing what we call a heart attack, a myocardial infarction. At other times, the lack of flow of oxygen to the heart muscle causes fatal arrhythmias that can cause the heart to stop beating. For example, ventricular tachycardia is one of these fatal arrhythmias that can occur as a result of lack of oxygen getting to the heart muscle. In fact, researchers have found that people with obstructive sleep apnea are 2.5 times more likely to suffer sudden cardiac death from 12 a.m. to 6 a.m. than people who do not have obstructive sleep apnea. Endothelin can also trigger the secretion of inflammatory cytokines like interleukin 1 and interleukin 6 and tuber necrosis factor alpha. And these can lead to insulin resistance and eventually to diabetes. Now, the good news is there is medication to treat central sleep apnea. And when obstructive sleep apnea is treated with continuous positive airway pressure, which is CPAP, with special CPAP machines that are masks with a machine that pumps pressure into the airways as we sleep, this can cause the reversal of many of the changes caused by obstructive sleep apnea, including a reversal of high blood pressure, prevention of heart failure, a decrease in insulin resistance, and a reduction in the chance of dying from sudden cardiac death. The take-home message is, if you snore or have excessive daytime sleepiness, then you should ask your doctor or provider to have you tested for sleep apnea. The CPAP machine is worth its weight in gold. Thank you for watching. I hope you liked the video and found it useful. If you did, share it with friends and family, leave your comments in the box below, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. We need your support. Thanks again.